Hey, welcome back to another episode. This is Ryan Swanstrom helping you learn a little bit more about the Cortana Intelligence Suite. Today, we're going to talk about resource groups. Resource groups are an excellent way to organize your tools within the Azure portal and within the Cortana Intelligence Suite. So, what are resource groups? Really, it is nothing more than just a collection of products you have within Microsoft Azure that are available lumped in together with what's called a resource group. How do you create a resource group? It's super simple out in the portal. We'll just walk through it right here. Go into the new button, and once you go into there, search for resource, and resource group will come up in your list. After you've found resource group, it will eventually show up over here. Now you can see it's at the top of the list. We click on that, go to create. It'll bring us up another blade, or we can type in the name of our resource group. We can select a subscription we want to use, a resource group location. So here's what I'm gonna name mine, Ryan Swanstrom-ML. I need a new resource group for some of the Azure ML stuff I'm gonna be doing. And you can choose your subscription here, and you can also choose a resource group location. I'm going to leave mine in, let's make mine in the South Central US. I'm going to put mine there. Another thing on naming your resource group, if your Azure account is just for yourself, you probably don't have to worry about adding your name into it. But if you have a group account within your organization or within your school, then it sometimes is a good idea to preface it with part of your name so that when other people look through resource groups, they can see who it belongs to. So after I've done that, I can pin it to the dashboard, click the button at the bottom, and then I can click the create button. And they create fairly quickly because it's not really creating a whole lot in the back end. It's just creating a container to hold some of your resources. And so there is my resource group. If I want to start adding new products, if I want to start adding some Azure storage in here or a database, I can just click on the add button and it'll take me to a new blade where I can start adding new products in there. If you want to find what resources or resource groups are available, you can click over on resource groups on the left. And I previously mentioned if you're a part of an organization, which I am, and you'll notice there's a whole lot of resource groups here. So I like to just go here and I search for my name, Ryan, and then now I can see these are all resource groups I have created for myself here. And the one that we just created, Ryan Swanstrom ML, it is there. And we can click on it and it takes us to that. So if you're interested in resource groups and how you can create them, this is a very quick little introduction and an overview of how you create them. I hope you find it helpful. And thanks for watching.